The Oncotype DX test is a very helpful test for men with low and low intermediate grade prostate cancer. And again, that's for men with Gleason 6 and Gleason 7 prostate cancer. And here's how it works. So think about those cells. And those cells are like Google Earth, and you can see the house. You can see the houses, you can see the neighborhood. What we want to do is we want to look deep in there. We want to look not only just inside the bedroom or not inside just the kitchen, we want to look inside the refrigerator. And that's what the Oncotype DX test does. It looks inside the refrigerator and it says how many bananas we have in there. Well, that's what those cells have. Those cells actually have several different aspects inside of them and several of those genes which are going to let us know how those cells are going to behave, not only just now, but also in the future. So the Oncotype test actually takes 17 genes. Those genes will let us know how those cells are going to behave in the future. Okay, so now we know that we can look into the future with those cells. And it's particularly important because with patients with a Gleason 6 prostate cancer, they don't all behave the same. It looks like it's a low-grade cancer. Everybody's happy about that. But there is a specific number of patients with low-grade cancer that actually will behave like a higher-grade cancer or potentially even an intermediate-grade cancer. And we want to know who those are. Because if we're going to follow this cancer, we want to have as much information as possible to minimize the chance that we could be missing somebody where that cancer could potentially grow and get outside of the prostate. One of the most important things about the Oncotype DX test is the fact of we get what's called a score. And that score is called the GPS score, okay? So that GPS score is going to come up with a number from 1 to 70, okay? If we have a GPS score which is low, that score is going to let us know that it is the chances that that cancer, that low-grade cancer, is going to continue to behave like a low-grade cancer is excellent, okay? So what we've done is we've looked inside those genes, we've opened up that refrigerator, and we said, you know what? This is going to behave like the average, you know, sort of household that we see here, okay? Now we look at another one, and that GPS score is high. And that GPS score is high, and what it says is it says that even though it looks like a Gleason 6 prostate cancer, it's got a higher risk that it's going to behave like a Gleason 7 prostate cancer. And what we know about Gleason 7 prostate cancers is they have a higher risk that they're going to grow and grow at a faster rate and get outside of the prostate. This is all about percentages. This is all about risks. And if we know that the risk that this low-grade cancer is going to behave like a low-grade cancer, we have more information and we certainly should feel more comfortable knowing that this is going to be a low-grade cancer and should behave like one. If we have a low-grade cancer and it looks like from a genetic perspective that it could behave like a high-grade cancer, that's somebody we need to think twice about in terms of following this cancer, and we may very well recommend a more aggressive approach for that man with a higher GPS score from the Oncotype DX test. Bottom line, we're now able to look. We can look into the inner workings of these cancer cells, and it gives us more information, and we can make a better decision together based on your cancer.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.